Hi there, Colorado owners. Today in your 2022 Chevrolet Colorado, we're going to be taking a look at and showing you how to install Tekonsha's P3 proportional trailer brake controller. What's nice about these proportional brake controllers is you get a much more natural braking, because when you hit the brake pedal, it detects that your vehicle is, it can feel that movement, and then the slowing down movement, the inertia sensor detects that, and it uses that to determine how intense to apply the brakes to help match your vehicle. You do still have, again, your options for setting your power. We've got a maximum being 14, and then you can go all the way down with it. The higher the power is set, the stronger the brakes will apply. We also have a boost here, which helps to engage the brakes a little bit more quickly, a little bit stronger. The boost setting here has three levels, and you can turn it off. Boost one is for when you have a trailer that is less than your vehicle or close to its weight. Boost two is for when you have a trailer that's similar in weight to your vehicle, maybe slightly higher. And boost three is for when you have a trailer that weighs more than your vehicle. You can help ramp up that output power to ensure that it does the job that you need it to match the vehicle that you're using to pull it with. On bottom right, you have your menu button. Here you can change options for your display. If you wanted to do that, you get your brightness, color, and contrast. You can see the X and the OK there. So this would be select, and this top one is back. We'll go back into the menu. Brake type. That's really cool here for this Tekonsha P3. One of the new things a lot of people are doing with their trailers to get a shorter stopping distance with more natural braking is going to an electric over hydraulic disc brake setup. And if we go in here, we can see you've got the option for electric or that hydraulic. So you got your options there for the various type of braking systems. Now there are a couple of more features in here that are a little bit hidden. You can find them in your manual. If you press both the menu and the boost button here at the same time and hold, this will bring up a trailer selection menu where you can actually save trailer profiles. Oh, come on. This will bring up a trailer selection menu where you can actually save trailer profiles. And you can have up to 5 different trailer profiles. That's really nice because maybe you've got a big camper that is electric over hydraulic, and you know you need the specific amount of brake put output for that trailer, you can set a profile for it. Maybe let's say you just got another trailer you use for work, and it's got electric brakes, and it's got different weight ratings, so you need to adjust the output to match that trailer and the style of brakes it has. You can easily set that up to another profile, so when you go to hook up to that whatever trailer that you're used to using frequently, just select the proper profile from there, and that way you don't have to redo your settings every time when you're swapping to different trailers. The last option that we have here is our reverse mode, and this just kind of temporarily disables the output, so that way you can back up your trailer or whatever if you're having some issues with it. It's really nice for maybe backing a boat down a boat dock or something. We'll begin our installation here on the driver's side. We're right down here at the kick panel. There's the parking brake pedal. I'm gonna go ahead and push it down just to help make things a little bit easier to see. And this panel here, we're gonna be removing. To remove the panel, you're just simply gonna pull up on it, so your fingers should be able to grip underneath of it here. And kind of at this middle point here, we're gonna pull up, and we're gonna be working our way towards the back of the panel, pulling up on it. There we go. Once you get the back released and you get towards the front here, you're gonna kind of pivot it like this and pull away from the wall here, because you got a clip right there. And that'll pop out of there. And then we can just set this panel aside. Behind our panel, you're gonna find your factory brake controller wiring, and it's just taped right here. Cut the tape, and that'll expose our wires there. We've got 4 wires here, and this will hook into our brake controller. In our P3 that we've got here, it does come with a harness. This is the harness that it comes with here. It has 4 wires on it as well, so everything will just match right up to what we've got right here, so we can make our connections. Now for demonstration purposes today, we're not gonna be fully mounting it. We're gonna use some hook and loop fasteners to secure it, and we're not gonna be opening up the little hardware pack that it comes with, so that way we can repackage that. So we're gonna strip back each one of these wires and hook them up. I like to do it one at a time, just because the red wire here is your hot wire. So once you strip it back, that wire's live there. So I kinda like to get that hooked up right away, to prevent it being stripped and potentially shorting out. So we're going to go ahead and just take our start with our red wire here. It has a green stripe on it. That's our main power wire. So we're just going to strip it back. You may want to trim a little bit off because it's got those little ends on it there. So we'll probably trim a little bit of this off and then strip it just to make it easier to strip with that material that it had on there. So give it a little twist, makes it slide into the butt connectors more easily. We'll slide our butt connector on there and then we'll attach our wire to it. We can now hook this up to the appropriate wire here on our new harness. That's going to be the black wire on our harness to power up our module, our brake controller. So we'll slide that in the other end of our butt connector and make our connection. So now that we've got that connected there, we're just going to repeat that process to connect the rest of our wires. We'll be hooking the blue wire in our harness to the blue wire here on the vehicle. That's the output from the brake controller, so that'll send it down this wire to the back. The white wire here on our harness is ground, and that'll actually hook to the black wire here on our vehicle. That'll be our ground. And then the red wire here on our harness is for the brake signal input to the brake controller. So that's coming from your brake pedal here. So it lets the brake controller know when you're pressing the brake pedal. And that'll connect to the white wire with the small blue stripe on it there. So I'm going to strip each one of these back and then make those connections, and then you'll see those here. All right. So now that we've got all of our connections made here, I'm going to reinstall this panel and kind of tuck my wiring out the top of it when I reinstall it. And we're going to be mounting our brake controller roughly in this location here. That way it's kind of out of the way. Our wiring will reach it easily. Position it just off to the left so we can still access our hood release switch. And that is now fully reinstalled. We still have access to our wiring there to be able to mount our controller. Now, typically when you mount your controller, you're going to screw the bracket straight into the dash. But again, for demonstration purposes, we're going to be using some hook and loop fasteners just to stick it there. So that way we don't mess up the dash here. That is not really how you want to leave your brake controller installed, because this is an inertia-based controller. So it needs to detect vehicle movement. So it is important you screw it in place. We can now take our brake controller here and mount it up. We're just going to line it up with the screws there and then install it. Line up with the screw holes. And then we'll use a 1/4-inch socket to run it down. All right, so now we got it mounted up. All that would be left is to plug it in. Our plug will simply just go right here into the back of the unit. The release tab you'll put facing up. Simply plugs in. Once we've got it plugged in, you can see instantly it powers up because it's getting power from the vehicle, right from those power and ground wires that we showed you there. And right away we're getting our indication that, hey, we don't have a trailer connected. So I'm going to go ahead and grab the test box that we've got that'll simulate a trailer load, and we can run through the options and verify everything's working properly. All right, we got our test box installed right there, and the first thing we see after plugging it into the 7-way at the back of the vehicle is that it no longer gives us that trailer not connected and that opening P3 screen. We've now got a picture of a vehicle with a trailer, got some numbers there, so it's now detected a trailer is connected. If we hit our manual slide, our tester here, we should get some amperage being drawn here. And there it is. Our brake controller is activating, and this is simulating trailer brakes. So we know it's sending an output, and we can see that the lights are also turning on, the left and right turn lights. So our brake lights would also come on in our trailer when we use our manual slide. Should still function when you hit the brake. Now, it's not gonna be as much intensity because this is an inertia-based system, which means it's gonna be a proportional brake controller. Proportional brake controllers, they supply their output based on that brake input that you're pressing the brake, and also with the movement of the vehicle and the settings that you currently have applied. You got your sensitivity and things like that. And that completes our installation of Tekonsha's P3 trailer brake controller on our 2022 Chevrolet Colorado.